You remind me of my last relationship, so I'm going to walk away from you. This is what I just got from a person who I was just getting to know. And when she said that to me, my response was, hey, I totally get it. Absolutely. I mean, I've felt the same way before. So by all means, I support your decision. Have a good one. But then the next day, I felt weird about this. I felt like I kind of chickened out on her. Now, just for the purpose of background, I have no honest, genuine feeling towards her at all. Like, I don't even know who she is. And to be absolutely honest, I have like many other women that I'm dating and I'm just kind of getting to know. Not like sex or anything, but just getting to know. So there was no personal, real agenda, right? And I wasn't really even attracted to her picture, or I didn't see anything even particular in her profile. Nevertheless, I felt weird the next day. I'm like, why is this feeling weird? Because I felt like I did not speak my truth. Because I believe dating is a spiritual progress. In other words, when I'm in the process of dating different women, and when I say dating, I'm not talking sex. I'm talking seeing other women with the purpose of considering a relationship. So when I'm in the process of dating, I am sharing my presence, my energy, my consciousness with these amazing, beautiful people. And through these get-togethers, there's a catalytic thing that takes place between two people. We can never meet another person without having an effect on them and they on us. Right? So we cannot not have an effect on each other. So as my journey in this life is to be honest, is to be truthful. So I feel like I did not speak the truth to her. So this morning, as I've kind of tuned into my truth, I realized, oh wow, I should have told her something. So I messaged her. I was like, listen, and I was sharing this with you in case you have the same challenge. And I told her, listen, this will be the last message you hear from me. I'm not genuinely, like, I'm not trying to like win you back or all that stuff. I genuinely want to share this with you because I feel like it's my responsibility. And I want others to do to me what I'm doing to you. And that is, if somebody triggers me emotionally in a relationship or in a dating situation, but I feel like I need to walk away from them, that usually is a very beautiful highlighting that there is a trauma taking place in me. That means there was a past trauma, some event of the past that my neurological system and physiological system has formed a memory to try to protect me. And that usually it manifests as some form of resentment. Now, if I walk away from this person, right? Like, she just met me, she has no idea who I am. I just send a voice note saying how I have silence days and it triggered her that I am spiritual and she just wants to get away. So I just basically shared that if I feel triggered about something like that, that's a sign in me that I am having a traumatic experience, and it's an opportunity for forgiveness. And forgiveness has different meaning to different people. But to me, it's an opportunity to see my enemy as myself and to actually get myself to a state of consciousness when I want them to be as happy as I want myself and my own lover and my own sister and my own mother to be. That's the forgiveness work that I really love and believe in. And that is, it's not just that we wish the other person not be harmed, but it's to go a step further. Is to actually see them as blessed. So if I want wealth and health and love and freedom and peace for myself, I see that person enemy who triggered me and who did me wrong, and in that same light. And that's how the teaching of Jesus Christ comes to mind, that he says, pray for your enemies. In the past, they said, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Jesus Christ says, and I say unto you, pray for your enemies. Bless them who curse you. Pray for them who despitefully use you. Why? Because when we do that, we are living under love. We are living in love. And love, according to Dr. R. Hawkins, is the most powerful force in the universe. Love is the most powerful force in the universe. I'm not talking romantic love. I'm not talking the thing that is basically an attachment, an aversion to a body. No, I'm talking about a state of love. I'm talking about a bliss feeling that takes you over. It's the feeling of oneness with all. I'm talking about that feeling of graciousness, grace. When you want to bless people secretly, silently, you're feeling so full. You're feeling so high. You're feeling so complete. There's not a trace of anger in you. It's impossible for you to be angry. It's impossible. So even if love, when you're in the state of love, right? Like I was just running the other day and I was like feeling this love, and I would see grumpy people walk by and I would smile at them. And it's so cute to see a grumpy person's face. It's like this, and they just go like a little bit like that. It's like a little baby who's angry. And when you come to them with full love, right? And you just smile, all of a sudden the baby's face goes from here to going like this. It's so cute. What I'm trying to say is that love is the most powerful force in the universe. So if there's any hint of resentment, of anger, of frustration, of anything in our relationship, in our dating journey or whatever, that's an opportunity for forgiveness. And forgiveness is to not only let go of grudges, but also see the other person as happy, as healthy, as blessed. And another note, I do this not just with the person, but also with the things that really frustrates me, right? Like things that really trigger me. Let's take vaccines, for example. It's a controversial topic, right? If whatever side of the argument, pro-vaxxing, anti-vaxxing, doesn't matter. I'm leaving my personal perspective out of this. But the point I'm trying to make is for us to like really unite in love, is to try to set aside our perspective and to just love the other side and to see the other side as blessed, as pray for them to for enlightenment, to awakening. Not pray for them to be destroyed, but pray for them to be illuminated. So that's a little side note on the topic of forgiveness to that. But I hope this makes sense at some level. Hope this makes sense on some level. And yeah, so I just send a voice note and I just let her, and I just did my job, and I said, I promise this is the last message that I sent you. But I felt this is a classy way to be, you know, because I could have easily let go of her and not message her, and then say, you know, sure, absolutely, not try to rock the boat. But instead, I shared what I felt was the truth, what I genuinely wanted another person to point towards me. Right, and sometimes truth is hard to swallow. I know she may get triggered, who knows, you know? But I did my job, you know? So that next person, she may get in a relationship again, and then she go through a whole cycle of resentment, whatever. And then at some point, she just, her heart's open, or she goes to an ayahuasca ceremony, or she goes to a meditation retreat, or she just sees one day in a beautiful sunset or sunrise, or she sees a beautiful flower, her heart opens right up, and then everything changes. She sees me, she sees him, she sees all the past in a new light. And that's the miracle of forgiveness that takes over our life and recontextualizes our entire relationship with another and the past and the future. That's why the teaching says the present determines the past. The present changes the meaning of the past. The past has no power. Because in the present moment, through the miracle of forgiveness, when our eyes see and our ears hear and our mind opens to a new possibility, the past changes its meaning. And when the past changes its meaning, the future's potentiality changes. And that's why in AA, the miracle occurs all the time. People come in after 20 years of abusing their body and stealing and cheating and lying and killing and raping. And they come in the presence of love, in the presence of love. They blossom and they bloom, and like rose bushes come out, bloom, bloom, bloom. And you see these people coming hurt, broken, and in the presence of love, in the frequency of forgiveness, in the spirit of brotherhood, they just rejuvenate and regenerate, and the past changes its meaning. They see all their past mistakes as a gracious blessing for them to come to this moment of love, of oneness. They recognize that even though they've lost a great deal on the material plane of form, they may have lost a few teeth or a few wrinkles here and there. Nevertheless, they gained something incredible. They gained an awareness of something invisible, an awareness of brotherhood and love and freedom from fear, what the world is seeking towards through material gains because of inner poverty. A lot of these people who had total breakdown have discovered something far greater. As Eckhart Tolle says, what is lost on the level of form is gained in the level of invisible form, the depth and the quality and the joy. So being sensitive to those relationships that trigger us, and then remind them in our mind, morning, evening, afternoon, as a routine, just like we go to shower. That's something that I'm learning to implement in my life, to really like bring in the spirit of forgiveness by seeing my enemy, by seeing the people who trigger me emotionally, mentally, physically, seeing them as blessed, seeing them as healed, seeing them as rich, seeing them as wealthy and in love, seeing them one with God, seeing them being able to receive direct transmission so that they may never hurt another. So that's my prayer to all. Thank you.